Man, I'm totally shocked with the improvement that he's made being traded over from OKC. Like, if he had played like that in OKC, they would have been nice, him and Russ.
Yeah, tough to play quite like that with Russ dominating the ball the way he was, but he's been amazing. He's in the dunk contest now.
All right, new topics here. We're going to move on now to our Super Bowl champion Eagles. Now, their offensive coordinator, Frank Reich, will be the new head coach for the Indianapolis Colts. Reich's been the OC for Philadelphia for the last two seasons. Chris Carter, how big of a loss will this ultimately be for the Eagles?
Well, I believe the head coach in Doug Peterson, Frank Reich was his blanket. You know, as a little kid, a kid has his blankie. Frank being a former backup in this league, him and Doug combined experience close to almost 30 years of playing in the NFL. There's a comfort level. And when you are a young head coach, which Doug is, there's only so many people that you can confide in as far as your weaknesses or things that you necessarily don't know. As a young coach, you like to project that, yeah, I know everything. But Frank was that guy for Doug that he could go to, and he could answer a lot of questions. The overall development, I think that we went through a period of time, the most undercoached position in the National Football League is the quarterback. But these guys got two of them. Right. Man, they got two guys who played in the league.
What do you mean the most undercoached position?
It's the most undercoached. If you look at guys where there's lack of coaching, it's the quarterback. It's not offensive line. It's not wide receiver. It's lack of fundamentals by quarterbacks. Now, we've gotten into an era where the quarterbacks are starting to get more specific, more specifically coached. So we believe they've improved the last few years, but it was an undercoached position. Wow. Me, how deep is Doug Peterson, is his coaching reservoir? Because this is what happens when you're successful.
Right.
Teams pluck your offense coordinator. They pluck your quarterback coach. Now, I wouldn't be as concerned if they didn't lose DeFilippo to Minnesota.
Right. That's their quarterback's coach who already went to Minnesota to be their OC.
I mean, so he doesn't have a coaching tree. He only been a head coach for 2 years. So he'd probably have to lean on Andy Reid and his resources to be able to find someone. I believe as a young coach and as a play caller, it's going to be more distracting with him being the head coach and all the other responsibilities around the team. How much of the X's and O's is he able to lean on with the other coordinator? So I believe it will be a problem going forward. How much of a problem, we don't know, but they do have Carson Wentz. Let's not forget that Carson Wentz is a stud. He knows the offense is his third year, so I don't believe it will affect him as much with Doug still being there. But when you are a young coach and you lose two of your lieutenants immediately, I would be naive to say, oh, this is not going to affect the Philadelphia Eagles.
The Eagles almost did the rare thing, win a Super Bowl and keep all their key coaches.
Yes.
They were this close. Obviously, Doug Peterson staying. Jim Schwartz, their D coordinator, his name was in some coaching discussions for head coaching jobs, but he didn't get it. And where is the offensive coordinator Frank Reich going? Indianapolis. Why does Indianapolis have an opening this late in the year? Because Josh McDaniels left him at the altar. Mm-hmm. Like, if Josh McDaniels just keeps his word, Philadelphia goes into next year with both coordinators intact from a defending Super Bowl champion, which is a rare thing. We saw the Patriots were able to do it last year, and then this year almost lost both of them, did end up losing one of them. So the Patriots, a few days after the Super Bowl, end up getting a slight win over Philadelphia. But you mentioned Carson Wentz. That is the key here. How many quarterbacks have we seen that part of the story of why they didn't get quite to where we thought they could was because of consistent turnover at either their head coach position or their offensive coordinator? Now, we've already seen Wentz. I don't want to say Wentz has realized his full potential, but when in year two, through three quarters of the season, you're the leading candidate for MVP, you're damn near close to your full potential. How much will the new offensive coordinator change what his success has already been? And when the quarterback's coach and offensive coordinator is gone, how confident are we that whomever the new OC is not going to change the system somewhat into something that Carson Wentz isn't as comfortable with? That's what I'm looking for.
Do I hear you both telling me that, yes, to your point, Chris, it would be naive to think there's not going to be an impact. Mm-hmm. There's going to be an impact. But because of the remnants of what Reich has been able to impart upon Carson, it won't be devastating.
Yeah. Is that the prediction? I don't believe it'll be devastating because it's not Frank Reich's system. It's a system that him and Doug Peterson created. It's a combination between Chip Kelly's old system and Andy Reid's West Coast system as far as getting rid of the ball quick. The RPOs and everything with a quarterback read option, those are from Chip Kelly. So sure. I would be more concerned if Doug Peterson was a defensive coordinator and they lost it. I would be more concerned. And I know this is Doug's system. It's not Frank Wright's system. So it's not going to be devastating, but it will affect especially young players. And if you look at the overall rapport between Nick Foles and Carson Wentz and their head coach, yes, you're bringing two new bodies in there. You're not only bringing a new head coach, new offensive coordinator, but you're also bringing a quarterback coach into this mix. I believe these coaches will adapt to the culture that they've established in Philadelphia.
Let me ask you this right quick, too, Nick. On the flip side of it, how will this affect Andrew Luck? Because people are wondering. Speculation is rampant. Mm-hmm. Some people, not necessarily me, but some folks on the streets are saying the concerns about Andrew Luck might have been part of McDaniel's reasons for pulling out.
Oh,
I'm just saying.
I think that definitely played a part of it. Now, I don't know that I believe he's going to have another shoulder surgery. If Andrew Luck has another shoulder surgery, it starts to become fair to question whether or not we've already seen the best we will ever see of Andrew Luck. Year three, mm-hmm. his last fully healthy year. But let's assume Andrew Luck's going to, after missing a full season, going to come back close to full strength. I'm excited for not only Luck, but for Frank Reich. A guy that, CeCe, you mentioned this late into the year. I think most fans did not know who the Eagles offensive coordinator was. And if you said the name Frank Reich, they weren't like, oh, that's the Eagles OC. They were like, oh, isn't he the guy that had the 35-3 comeback with Buffalo over Houston? Like, that's how they knew him.
Yes.
Frank Reich did a good job in San Diego, now Los Angeles, but at the time it was San Diego, with Phillip Rivers. He did an excellent job with Philadelphia, with a rookie quarterback, then a second-year quarterback, then fitting in Jay Ajayi, then developing some of the Doug Peterson RPO stuff. I'm excited to see him with a guy. He's not going to run a lot of that RPO stuff. A different type of system with a different type of quarterback with Andrew Luck. Now, all of it keys on what you alluded to. How healthy is Andrew Luck? But a guy that kind of went under the radar. He was the coordinator we didn't talk about. Everyone talked about Jim Schwartz. Mm-hmm. Didn't talk as much about Frank Reich. I'm excited to see him in Indianapolis.
And I believe the Colts got very lucky. Now, if they can get that horseshoe to rub Andrew Luck and get Andrew Luck back to being healthy, I believe this could be a great, just late sneak hire. Because the quarterback, offensive coordinator, head coach relationship is critical. And Indianapolis, they've had great quarterback play. But have they really helped out the quarterback? Most of their quarterbacks being coached up by defensive head coaches. Mm-hmm. This is the first offensive head coach that they've had in Indy for a long time. So I look forward to that relationship being built. Andrew Luck, hoping that he's healthy because the NFL is a better place with Andrew Luck being on the field.
Yeah, I agree with that for sure. So coming up, are the Patriots indeed a fear-based organization? Somebody said it.
We're going to check out what these streets are saying.
Let's check out what the streets are